Dogumentary TV, producing the best breed documentaries on YouTube.
For the right owner, a properly bred Boerboel is the most fantastic dog on the planet. I'm Kyle from Rocky Acres, and I'm going to tell you about the Boerboels from the AKC standpoint. In 2006, the American Boerboel Club was founded and started work on having the breed recognized by the American Kennel Clubs. So in 2006, they were accepted into the Foundation Stock Service Program, which is kind of the foot in the door to full AKC recognition. In 2010, the Boerboel was accepted into the AKC miscellaneous class, which is where they start out in the show ring, competing against all dogs in the miscellaneous class. December of 2014, the Boerboel became eligible to be fully recognized by the American Kennel Club. Then January 1st of 2015, the Boerboel was completely recognized by the AKC and was allowed to compete in the shows in the working group. So the breed standard for the AKC Boerboel says that dogs should be between 24 and 27 inches in height and the bitches 22 to 25 inches in height. There is no real maximum weight for the dog or minimum. What's important is balance. You don't want a dog that is so heavy that it could not perform its duties as a guardian or a farm dog. So as far as the body goes, length to leg ratio should be 10 to 9, with the back, length of the back being just a little bit longer than the dog is tall. The head is big, blocky, and square. The muzzle should be a little more than one-third the length of the top of the skull. So they actually have a muzzle. They do not look like a bull mastiff. A scissor bite is preferred, but an underbite of less than a quarter inch is also acceptable. As far as their muzzle goes, the jowls, they should be tight. That's preferred, but they can hang down a bit. The longer the jowl, the less desirable it is. Their top line should be firm and level. So from the back of the shoulders to the croup, you should see a nice level line that keeps its shape while the dog is in movement. The tail is set fairly high, and it's not the length of the tail that matters, it's the set of the tail. If a dog's tail is docked, it should be docked at the third to fourth caudal vertebrae, and a dog with a naturally long tail should curve gently downward about as long as the hock goes. The chest should be broad, front legs should be straight, toes pointing forward. The hindquarters is muscular and strong with nice moderate angulation in the stifle area, and the rear toes should also be facing forward. Those are the big things that should stand out when you're looking for a well put together dog. There are a lot of other things to go into, but those are pretty much it. The coat is sleek, it's shiny. The colors are any shade of brown. So it's like from a really light cream fawn to a rich mahogany. There's brindles. They're also Irish marked, as long as there's not too much white and no freckling within the white portions. Eyes should be dark, definitely no yellow eyes. The Boerboel temperament should be strong and courageous, should not be fearful. It should not be overly aggressive. Ideally, you want the dog to be protective, but allow you as the owner to make the decision when to allow a friendly stranger. So for dogs showing, they may not be the most amenable dog to strangers, but they need to be trained to stand, to allow a judge to go over them, and not to be aggressive toward other dogs in the show ring. An overly aggressive dog is just as bad as an overly fearful dog. So they should be stable, very stable in temperament. There's a lot of different theory on the makeup of these dogs. They were originally used as war dogs in the Boer Wars. They were used to guard diamond mines and ultimately became the farmer's guardian, which is where the name Boerboel comes from. It means farmer's dog. And as the breed developed, there were many different breeds in there, none confirmed because there was not a lot of documentation back in the day. But some said the Canaan dogs are in there, a Khoi dog, which is related to today's Basenji, Rhodesian Ridgebacks. Later on, the Bull Mastiff was believed to be introduced into the breed. And with recent genetic testing available, it shows that in these lines, there definitely is Boxer, Rhodesian Ridgeback, Bull Mastiff, and some of the American Bulldog. But again, nothing is set in stone from way back because no one kept accurate records back then. The breed was originally bred to be a guardian, a family guardian, a farm guardian, and encompassed in that would be a livestock guardian. So today's purposes, there are still people that use them for farms and livestock. Mostly they have become home and family guardians. Because of the dominant nature of the Boerboel, an owner needs to be experienced with dominant dogs. They need to be a strong and consistent leader, someone who can set boundaries, be consistent with it. They need a lot of training and exposure, and it has to be consistent training. You can't work with your Boerboel today for 10 minutes and then next month bring them out and work with them again. Consistent training, work with them every day, expose them to people, places, things. You'll get a much more tolerant and well-rounded dog. The main difference between the American Kennel Club and the South African Boerboel Breeders Association when it comes to the Boerboel breed standard is the acceptance of the black dog. SABS, the South African Boerboel Breeders Society, and NABA, the North American Boerboel Breeders Society, accept the black dog. The AKC folks and the old-time hardcore Boerboel folks in South Africa do not believe that the black dog is a true Boerboel. Their belief is that something with the black color, be it Corso, Great Dane, Labrador, was stuck in there to create the black dog, mostly for monetary gain. I guess in a purist world, there is no black Boerboel. So that's the biggest point of contention between the two registries. So as far as the AKC history with the breed goes, when the American Boerboel Club was being formed, the original Boerboel standard was taken into consideration and basically moved into verbiage that the AKC desired. So the breed standard was not changed from the South African dog to the American Kennel Club dog. The American Boerboel Club, which is the parent club for the breed to the AKC, is doing its best to preserve that original Boerboel by maintaining a strong standard, doing a lot of judges' education so that when judges are presented the breed in the ring, they know what that true Boerboel looks like. And from there, hopefully those who choose to breed actually read the standard and look at the standard and breed toward that standard. That's how we're striving to preserve the breed. There are folks that see this breed as a moneymaker, and they will take what should be perhaps a dog that should be no more than 180 pounds, make it 200, 225, 250, and start selling their dogs as this big, giant, wonderful creation. But that's not true to the breed. That's not what the breed really is. They cannot do the job they were intended to be at that weight. There are also those that will just say, hey, I have a nice dog, you have a nice dog, let's have puppies. That's how the breed gets ruined. It's not by a kennel club, it's not by dog shows, it's by people not really knowing what they're doing, and just going about doing their own thing. Socialization and training of the Boerboel is a must. These dogs are large, they are smart, they are dominant. And without structure, without consistent training, without an owner that can build on these building blocks by being mutually respectful, it's not by beating your dog into submission, it's by earning their trust, gaining their respect, and working as a team, you can do anything with your Boerboel, provided that they are well-bred and have a correct temperament. But without socialization and training, you have a train wreck. Boerboels are very intelligent. They're easily trained, easily housebroken. They are stubborn, but because of their desire to please their owner, it adds to their trainability. Depending on the individual dog would be how you would best go about training it. Some are very food motivated, some are motivated for praise, and some even motivated for the reward of playing with a little toy. So you just have to know your dog and what motivates it. And you might figure that out within the first few days of ownership, or as the dog matures and changes, what he wants to work for may change, so you've got to adapt with it. Boerboels need a good amount of exercise. They're a big dog, they are an athletic dog, and if you have them in your yard, they need a good couple hours outside a day to run around and play in your yard and exercise with you. At least two long walks a day, along with some mental stimulation. It's just not the physical exercise, it's the mental stimulation that helps make these a happy breed as well. They should be able to come in the house and be a couch potato with you when it's time, but if they do not have adequate exercise, and that includes outdoor running, outdoor playing, they'll become destructive. They'll be an unhappy dog. The Boerboels average 10 to 12 years. Unfortunately, Boerboels have a lot of health issues. They are prone to hip dysplasia, elbow dysplasia, allergies, entropion, ectropion, cancer, heart issues, thyroid issues, just about anything any other large breed dog could come across. What we see a lot of are hip and elbow dysplasias and allergies. So for growing a healthy Boerboel puppy, you want to be sure they have adequate exercise, but not too much. They're a big dog, they grow rapidly, so you don't want a lot of strain on the joints, but you want enough to promote healthy muscle structure, bone structure, ligaments. For feeding your puppy, there is no set amount to feed them. Smaller meals are better, depending on the age of your puppy. You know, 3 meals a day is great. I try to keep my pups at about a 30% protein rate, no more than that, an average of 9% fat content, and ideally a 1-to-1 or 3-to-1 ratio of calcium and phosphorus. The calcium and phosphorus are hugely important for healthy bone and tissue growth. The Boerboel is really pretty easy to care for as far as grooming goes. They need their nails done on a regular basis like any other dog, and depending on the surface that they roam about, some more, some less. A simple brushing a couple times a week is great for their coat. They do shed a lot all year. But again, brush a couple times a week. If you're in a warmer environment and you have the access, give them a bath a couple times, you know, once, twice a month. I wouldn't do any more than that because it dries out the natural oils in their coat. They really don't need a whole lot of grooming. Wiping out their ears every week is important because they are so prone to yeast infections. You want to keep a good eye inside those ears so you know what's going on with the ears. So Bakari is one of my boys. He was very large. He was at 175 pounds, very muscular and thick. He was injured. So during his rehab phase, which he's still in, I've taken a lot of weight off of him. He has one of the best temperaments all the way around. He is guardy, but when he thinks the situation calls for it, he is the biggest cuddler, welcoming, happy dog on the planet. He's got a great head, great top line. He's a very well-structured dog. He's working on his obedience titles. Even though he's 6 years old, he's getting a late start. But he's a real good boy, good lines, good confirmation. So Dika, she is a very opinionated young dog. She's 3 years old, acts like a puppy, pretty much listens when she chooses to. She's not mean, she's not aggressive. She's just a powerful, powerful puppy. She has excellent conformation, all the way from her head, top line, angulation, beautiful dog. Rocky Acres Makina, she's the one with the tracking dog title and several other obedience titles, working on her conformation title. The name Makina in Afrikaans is the happy one, and she is indeed the happy one. She is the one that goes everywhere that I go and greets everybody with enthusiasm. Crazy happy girl. So in conclusion, in all my years of dog ownership, which is many, the Boerboel is the absolute best guardian and companion, in my opinion. Given the right breeding, which accounts for 90% of the temperament, and the right owner, they are amazing pets. The American Boerboel Club, which is the parent club to the American Kennel Club, has a list of approved breeders. We promote health testing to help ensure genetic potential and the health of the dog. The breed has many issues, so as the American Boerboel Club, we want to promote health and health testing to ensure the longevity of your dog and you have your companion as long as you possibly can. So if the Boerboel seems like it's something that appeals to you, please do your research. Research the breeders, research the temperament of the dogs they breed, and have an understanding of your capabilities as the pack leader, as the owner, and what your responsibilities will be for the lifetime of this dog. You can make a very successful relationship and enjoy 10 to 12 years of dog bliss done correctly.